Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial, we will discuss a very important feature in SolidWorks, and that is forming tool, which is basically using sheet metal domain. So let's go to your SolidWorks, and here you can see that I am using SolidWorks 2020. If you are using a below version of SolidWorks or a future version of SolidWorks, you can still follow this tutorial. First of all, we will create the forming tool, then we will save this forming tool to the design library, and then we will fetch that forming tool from a design library and we will use that forming tool. Okay, so let's go to your new, select part and select OK. And now we are in SolidWorks interface. So first of all, I will change my background to plain white, and my I will set my units to mmjs. Okay, so let's first draw the forming tool. So let's go to your top plane, select the sketch. Here I will draw, let's say, one circle having diameter let's say 80 millimeters. Okay, let's go to your features, extruded boss, and I will extrude this in the reverse direction, let's say 10 millimeters, and select OK. Now I will draw another circle on the back side. So select this face, select sketch, and I will draw another circle keeping this origin as center, and let's say here the diameter is let's say 50, okay, or maybe let's say 60. Okay, let's go to your features, extruded boss, and this time I will extrude it let's say 20 millimeters, and select OK. Now I will draw some fillet on these sharp edges. So let's go to your fillet, I will select this edge and I will select this edge, and let's say I will use a fillet of maybe 4 or let's say maybe 5. Okay. Okay, now I will use extrude cut command to cut out this portion, because we don't want this portion. So let's say I will select front plane, select the sketch, view normal, and here I will use a corner rectangle. I will select this line, I will select this edge, and I will make it collinear. Okay, now I will delete this part, I will extrude cut this part. So I'll go to your features, extruded cut, and first I will rotate it so that you can view it in isometric. Here I will use mid plane, and I will use, let's say, up to 100. So now we can use a forming tool. So let's go to your sheet metal, and here you will find this option, forming tool. And for the stopping face, I will select this surface, and I will leave this faces to remove as it is. And insertion point would be, let's say, this point, okay, right in the center, and I will select OK. Now you can see that the color of this part is changed, and now I have to save this part in the design library. So I'll go to here, save, I will select this save as, and I will save as it as form tool. Okay, form tool is this one, okay, form tool, and I'll change its directory, program data, and then I will search for SolidWorks, and then SolidWorks 2020, design library, and then forming tools, embosses, and here I will, let's say, rename it as let's say deep draw. Okay, and I will save it. Now I will create another sheet metal part, and then I will use this forming tool onto that new sheet metal part. So let's go to your new, select part, and select OK. And here we create a very basic sheet metal part with, let's say, 2 or 3 flanges. So let's go to your top plane, select sketch. Here I will use, let's say, center point rectangle. And let's say this dimension is 150, okay, and let's say this one is 200, okay, or maybe 250, okay. Let's go to your sheet metal base flange, 2 millimeter sheet thickness, select OK. Now I will use edge flange here, let's say 100. and let's say one edge flange maybe here. Okay, select OK. Let's use this design library, and here you can see that my design library is missing. So basically I have to link my design library. So let's go to here, this one, add file location, and here I'll go to here program data, and then SolidWorks, and then SolidWorks 2020, then design library, and then forming tools, and select OK. Just go to here, forming tools, right click, and select this one, forming tool folder. Okay, select yes, and now I can use my forming tools. So select this one, embosses, and here you will find all the embosses that you have already created. Here you can see that I have already created, let's say, new emboss or a new logo, part 2, etc. And for this tutorial, I have created this one, deep drawing. Now I can use that forming tool onto this sheet metal part. So just drag and drop. And here I can flip this. And I can change its angle, I can change its position. But I think I will leave all these as it is, select OK. Now you can see this one. And let's say I want to use another drawing, deep drawing part here. And let's say maybe one here. Okay. So that concludes this exercise. I hope you like it. And if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.